Okay, thank you for that video, Guru Reggie.
So please everyone give him a hand, Pastor Roy.
Praise the Lord. Thank you so much for those poor people who clap their hands. Praise the Lord. Well, we thank God for this joyous occasion that we can come together and witness the dedication of Raphael Joaquin. Now, I'll take a short time to explain what child dedication is all about. This is a biblical practice. I'd like to read two passages, one from the Old Testament and the other from the New Testament. In the Old Testament, there was a woman who was barren. She'd been waiting, she'd been asking God for a son. And when finally the Lord opened up her womb and she got pregnant, she made this prayer. She said, I prayed for this child and the Lord has granted me what I have asked of him. So now I give him to the Lord. For his full life, he will be given over to the Lord. And so this was the dedication of Samuel, the prophet Samuel in the Old Testament. And so dedication is a time when the parents would recognize that this baby is from the Lord. And they would dedicate this baby, give his life for the Lord. Now, obviously, the baby later on has to make that own personal decision in his life to dedicate his life to the Lord. But right now, as parents, Chi and Grace would like to have this dedication so that they can acknowledge that indeed it is the Lord who owns and guides this child. Now, friends, I want to convince you how important parenting is today. There are a lot of wild children today because of poor parenting. I remember the true story of two fathers. They both live in New York. One father's name, Max Jukes. He didn't believe in the Lord. He didn't go to church. He didn't take his children to Sunday school even if they wanted to. And so he just raised his children with no guidance from the Lord. Max Jukes had 1,026 descendants, 1,026 descendants. Of the 1,026, 300 were sent to prison, 190 became prostitutes, and 680 were alcoholics. Max Jukes and his children contributed nothing to society. In fact, the family of Max Jukes became a liability to society. About the same time, in the state of New York, there was another father by the name of Jonathan Edwards. He is a pastor, he is a minister of the Lord. He brought his children to church and made sure his children would read the Bible. Jonathan Edwards had 929 descendants. Of the 929 descendants, 430 became ministers of the gospel, 86 became university professors, 13 became university presidents, 75 of his descendants authored good books, 7 of his descendants became congressmen in the U.S. Congress, and then 1 became vice president of the United States of America. Friends, we can underestimate the influence that parents have on their children, but we also need to recognize that parenting is not easy for 3 major reasons. Number 1 is the issue of money. I know it's expensive to raise children today. They say that poverty is hereditary. You can get it from your children. But second reason why parenting is tough is because of the issue of maturity. Not just the issue of money, but the issue of maturity. I mean, as parents, I'm sure you're not yet perfect, and you need to learn how to raise your son. And sometimes it's trial and error, mostly errors, but again, we need all the help that we can get. And that's why, friends, Chi and Grace have asked several of their friends and their loved ones to stand as co-parents with them because they realize how tough it is to raise children today. Not only the issue of money, not only the issue of maturity, but the issue of morality. Every child born on earth today will have to grow in an atmosphere of violence, in an atmosphere of immorality. So many kids today are so hooked into pornography. In fact, there's a movie right now and people are just, you know, hooked into pornography. And we have to raise our children with these issues of so much immorality in our midst. And so now, Chi and Grace, they had to ask their friends and relatives to come here to the front to act. In the Filipino context, they are called Ninong or Ninang. They're called godparents or co-parents. So I'd like them to call them and so that they can come here in front.
So at this time, can we please call up the Ninangs and please stand with me on the right? So can we please call up Rhoda Arvado? Kaylee Briones? Michelle Castillo? And Michelle Encon-Benda? So if you are called, can you please stand to my right? Kathy Marisiga and Sheila Laxamana and lastly Tamara Laxamana. So if you're coming, please stand to the right.
And last is Amanda.
And now can you please call the Ninos? So okay, if you guys can line up on my left, can you please come, John Bansil, John Sequoza, Gerard Sequoza, Garfield Samuels, Aaron, I'm really bad at pronunciation, Aaron Gatley, and then Jess Perez. Rashid Talib. And lastly, Ravindra Chakrapal.
Alright, so we have here the grandparents, the Ninangs and the Ninongs. Again, the reason why Chi and Grace requested you to stand as a co-parent with them, they realize it's not easy to raise children today, so they will need all the support that they can get. And so your task as godparents is to help pray for Raphael Joaquin, pray for him, to support the parents as much as you can. We know it's your moral support. And sometimes, you know, they will need some needs, not just emotionally. Sometimes they will need some financial needs. And so you are there to be a co-parent and to help Raphael to grow in the grace and the knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. So friends, being a co-parent is not just to make sure that Joaquin or Raphael Joaquin will receive a gift on his birthday, but more so as a moral and spiritual support to Grace and Chi in raising Raphael. And so we'll be praying for you right now. I'd like to Chi and the Grace to come here. And then we'd like the guys to please just lay your hands on the shoulder here, the ladies on the shoulder of the mother, Grace. And so we will be praying right now. We're not just dedicating the baby, we're dedicating the parents. And we're dedicating you as the co-parents. Please join us, let's bow your hands and pray with us. Our Heavenly Father, we come before you in the name of your Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you for this privilege that you've given these men and women to stand as a co-parent with Chi and Grace. Lord, we pray that you will put into their hearts the burden, the desire, to see Raphael Joaquin grow to become the man that God designed him to be. Lord, we pray that the lives of these men and women who are standing as co-parents will be an example in the eyes of Raphael, that when he looks at them, he will be able to say, I'd like to become like my Nino or my Nina. And so Lord, I pray for these men and women right now as they lay their hands on the father and the mother of Raphael. Lord, we pray that they will continue to lift this family in prayer and support this family in any way they can. Thank God again for the privilege that you have given them to stand as a co-parent for Raphael Joaquin. So we commit them to you right now. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Alright, praise the Lord. You may take your seats. We're going to ask the mother and the father to join us here now. Okay, this is the dedication. It's the dedication of the parents dedicating their baby to the Lord. And so I'll be asking she and Rester to be together. I'll be at the civic center here for the microphone. And so this is the pledge that they're giving to the Lord as they raise Raphael Joaquin. In the grace and knowledge of the Lord Jesus Christ. They have two microphones, it's good. So I'll call these four graves. Okay, let's listen to the pledge these parents are doing or saying before the Lord and before this congregation. Together now? Ready? Read.
On this very special occasion, meaning in the presence of our loved ones and friends, they pray our son, Raphael Joaquin, to the Lord. May this act of dedication to acknowledge that Raphael Joaquin belongs to God and accept our responsibility as stewards to love our son. Care for him and teach him to grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. May this act of dedication be to commit yourselves to lead by examples, to guide Raphael Joaquin, faith in Christ, and to train him to love the Lord and live according to his will. By this act of dedication,
we offer our son, Raphael Joaquin,
to the Lord for his use, knowing that God blesses those who hope that we help us, Lord, to be faithful and diligent.
Give us your strength and wisdom.
And we might, that we might do our duties well as Raphael Joaquin's parents. We commit these things in Jesus' name.
Amen. Praise the Lord. I request everyone now to please stand and join us as we dedicate Raphael Joaquin to the Lord. For a special protection upon Raphael Joaquin. And Father and Lord, we want to dedicate you as well, the parents, G and Grace, that they will become the father and the mother who you will use to mold their son to become the kind of man that you want him to be. And so Lord, we dedicate this boy and his future to you. We dedicate for everything that he will need in order to grow and become a responsible citizen of this country, and most especially that he will become your child so that someday he too will come to the same challenge of the Lord Jesus Christ. So Lord, we just unite our hearts right now in thanking you for accepting this glory. And indeed, you will use it for your glory and for your honor. We ask all of this in Jesus' name we pray, and God's people say, amen, amen. Let's give praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Thank you, Pastor Roy. And now, everyone's favorite part. Ooh, guess what it is? No, it's more games. No, just kidding, it is food.
You are. Tulo ka.
Thank you.
rough, 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 rough.